Under the Constituency Development Fund, CDF, each MP would get 10 million shillings annually to facilitate development activities in constituencies until it was abolished by the Parliamentary Commission in 2011 for lack of accountability and misuse of the fund by some MPs. However, MPs now want the Constituency Development Fund to be reinstated to help them close a gap of huge constituency demands.
My constituency, there are rumors that the CDF still exists. And it is us, the members of parliament, who is not taking this money to the constituency, which is not the case here in parliament. But now, if this CDF is back, it will at least do something, because as a member of parliament, if I have that CDF, I'll get an opportunity to say, this is what is given in this financial year to help our constituency.
Now that the fund is no longer there, all the burdens is on the member of parliament. And I pray that our commissioners, the speakers, should really discuss this intensely, and if possible, the Constituency Development Fund should be reintroduced back so that we released other pressure that we have currently.
As they returned from the Christmas break, MPs decried the stress they went through during the festive season as voters camped in their homes with several demands, including food, meat, alcohol, building roads, paying school fees and funeral costs, among other requests that overwhelmed their capacity.
At this particular time, the festive season, I am telling you, people will be flocking into your home. Everything a member of parliament should provide. The moment you refuse to provide, they term you as someone who is so greedy, someone who is useless, and they don't know the role of a member of parliament. They think that your role is to give them support.
The situation is that there is no money. There's too much, a lot of demands from the constituency, which we cannot actually meet.
Legislators claim the government has abandoned service delivery in constituencies and put a big burden on MPs to deliver government services to people, which is very unfair to them. Some legislators say they decided to hide from their voters by not traveling to their villages for Christmas.
Get challenged by all kinds of problems of the community, personal, communal, and developmental, and this is the biggest challenge. One, construction of roads, maintenance of water sources, boreholes, equipping of hospitals. These are basically services that members of parliament just pretend over their provision. That should not be within our means to provide.
So those issues cannot be addressed by government as whole, because there are a lot of demands coming to members of parliament. There are demands which are personal in nature, which the government cannot also address. But there are certain demands which calls for the attention of the government.
Let government start doing its role properly so that services should be enough for the community. People are acting so because they are not feeling government the way they are supposed to.
Lawmakers now want the government to not only reintroduce the Constituency Development Fund, but also bring a bill to provide an enabling law for the fund. Some claim that although the fund was scrapped 12 years ago, voters are not aware and continue to harass them, accusing them of failure to make use of the CDF. They also call for a bigger fund and not 10 million as it was then.
Unless this money is increased, otherwise it being reinstated as it was, even if it's 100 million per annum, it will increase more pressure, because the constituents might think that members of parliament have been given money to do these services. What we all need is government to take up its mandate.
Dennis Nyangweso, the Samia Bugwe Central Legislator, who also sits on the Budget Committee, says MPs have tried reporting their constituency demands to the government, but they all turn out as non-funded priorities in national budgets. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.